2005. After that, she did her MSc nursing from prestigious College of Nursing, All India Institute of Medical Science, New Delhi in 2009. Now she is pursuing PhD in nursing from National Institute of Nursing Education, PGIMER, Chandigarh. She is president of Chandigarh of Nursing Teachers Association of India. And ma'am has lifetime membership in various other nursing associations, such as National Neonatology Forum, Indian Association of Neonatal Nurses, Trained Nurses Association of India, and founder member of Pediatric and Neonatology Nursing Forum. She is an eminent teacher, researcher, and orator. Gitanjali ma'am has published more than 32 research papers in various nursing journals. This shows her interest in this field. Ma'am has received various awards such as Best Oral Paper Award, Young Researcher Award, and Best E-Paper Award. She has presented her valuable research papers in many conferences. She has also successfully organized and chaired many conferences and workshops. Ma'am has participated in more than 43 conferences as a guest faculty. And she has also written chapters in many prestigious nursing books. Now, without much ado, I would like to hand over the screen to today's speaker, respected Mrs. Gitanjali Kalyan ma'am, and would request to start her speech on topic bibliography and style of writing reference.
Thank you, Akanksha Singh. And I also thank President of NTAI Association, Mr. Farooq Khan, for giving me this opportunity to be a part of this conference and to present a session in the conference. So today I'm going to talk about very important topic, that is bibliography and styles of writing references. So when we are writing any assignments or any research project, thesis, journal article, it is very important to search the literature, to save it, organize it, and when you are writing the paper, you have to reference it, or you have to put the bibliography at the end. So we are going to start the session. This is my institute. This is the National Institute of Nursing Education where I am teaching. And this is my clinical area, that is Advanced Pediatrics Center, where we take our students, our BSc students, master's students, postgraduate students, and they get exposure. It is one of the best tertiary care institution of North India. Not only North India, we must say that it is one of the best premier institute of the nation. And this is a temple of learning, and I am thankful to Almighty for giving me opportunity to work in such an institution, in prestigious institutions. So for the today's session, the objectives are, at the end of the session, we expect that the participant should be able to describe what is reference list, what is bibliography, and what is annotated bibliography. These three things are different, and many a times the students get confused that what is the difference between the three. Then differentiate between reference list and the bibliography, and list different styles of reference writing. Recognize that the format for writing references is different for different types of sources. There are different types of sources from which we access the information, and it is a different format for every type of source you are referencing depending upon the style you have chosen. Right? Understand the use of reference management software and name different reference management softwares and how to use those reference managers. Right? So I'm going to start with the introduction. Referencing is a system used by academicians to indicate the source of ideas, theories, quotes, facts, or any other evidence, data, and information that has been used for assignment, thesis, journal article, or book chapter. The major purpose of reference writing is to discourage plagiarism and give credit to the scholars or the researcher or the inventors for their efforts in the growth of knowledge. So it is very, very important to acknowledge somebody's work. Whatever the work somebody has done, when you are using it in your work, when you are writing it, your referencing is very, very important. Until unless you give the credit to people, you cannot prove that your data is also authenticated, right? So referencing is a standardized way of acknowledging the sources of information and ideas used in assignments. It allows the sources to be identified. It is very important to be consistent, when you are referencing. So there are many benefits of referencing. First one is recognize the scholarly knowledge of another author, provide support, specific facts or the claims. So whatever the claim you have made, say for example, you are writing a paper and you are saying that the hearing loss among preterm babies due to noise, high noise levels in the NICU is 2 to 10%. So you have to have a reference. This is a reference which we have taken from a Cochrane review, which is being published by after the systematic analysis in the Cochrane review, which is considered as one of the highest reference, right? Help in cross-checking the facts. It increases the credibility of the work. Until unless you reference properly, say for example, you are writing 2 to 10% of the preterm babies get deaf after high noise in NICU, and you are not given reference, any reference to it, nobody is going to believe it. From where you taken? How can you claim this? To claim that particular fact, you have to have a reference, and until unless you have a reference, your work is not a credible work. It reflects the extent of literature review. Citing the references informs the readers the source of more information. So if you have given the references in the end, the people, those who are referring your work, they can review the references, they can cross-check the references, they can read from the references more about, and that will bring more clarity about the concepts which you have put into your writing. So these are all the benefits of referencing, and until unless you quote a reference, your work is not credible. So remember that. So now another very important topic we are going to discuss is difference between reference list and bibliography. The reference list contain only those sources that the researcher actually referred in the text. So whatever you have referred, you would be entering the number sequence wise in your the Word document, and then you would be listing them at the end. And reader could refer the references and evaluate the correctness of the statement. On the other hand, if you talk about bibliography, is listing all the material that have been consulted while writing anything, research report, assignments, etc., whatever you are doing it. The list of references is given at the end of the text. It may or may not be cited in the text. So you will just get all the references at the end of the chapter, and these references, this bibliography is not cited in the text. It's not written that after a particular line, like I gave you the example of hearing loss among 2 to 10% of the preemie babies because of the high levels in NICU. High level of noise in the NICU. So here they won't be quoting that number one Cochrane reference review. They won't be quoting. In the end, all the references would be, bibliography would be written at the end. So this is the reason it is called bibliography. It is not being cited, but it is being quoted at the end of the text. However, bibliography does not support the argument, but one only refers them in the personal way. So it's not supporting the argument that this particular reference we have taken from here. It is just reflecting that while writing a particular chapter or particular document, we have referred these references, but we are not claiming that which one has been taken from which. Right? Both bibliography and references appear at the end of the document, but remember that bibliography comes after the reference list. Say for example, if you've written a Word document, on any title, sometimes both references or bibliography is being quoted. So first you have to quote the references, and that would be quoted in the text as well. And in the end, you can write the bibliography. In addition, you have referred something. A bibliography may contain all those that have appeared in the reference list, but it may also contain the additional sources which have been referred. So coming on to the annotated bibliography, it provides information regarding the research that has been done on a given topic. It is an alphabetical list of citations to books, articles, and documents. Each citation is followed by a brief, usually about 150 words, descriptive and evaluative paragraph called annotation. So this is annotated bibliography, which is entirely different than the bibliography. So you have to understand that bibliography is something else than the annotated bibliography. The purpose of annotation is to notify the reader of the relevance, accuracy, and quality of sources cited. So now annotation versus abstract. So as we said, there is 150 words paragraph, descriptive in nature, and evaluate the particular content which you have read and described. So now sometimes students get confused, what is annotation, what is abstract. It is also 150 words, it is also a kind of brief about a particular topic. So let us see what is the difference. Abstract is a descriptive summary of journal article. It is often found at the beginning. On the other hand, if you talk about annotation, though annotation is also a summary of article or of any other document, but it is more descriptive and critical. It exposes the author's point of view, clarity, and appropriateness of expression and authority, and it is usually at the end of the document. Now, coming on to the referencing styles, which is very, very important to understand before you learn to publish or you start publishing. And you have to understand that different journals, they follow different referencing style, and we need to adhere to the referencing style when you are submitting any paper to the journal. So some common widely used citation styles include Vancouver, APA, that is American Psychology Association, Harvard, then MLA, that is Modern Language Association, Chicago, that also referred as Servian. So out of these three, out of these five, the first three are important, and out of those three, first two, that is Vancouver and APA style, is most commonly being used. So Vancouver style, the Vancouver style formally known as uniform requirement for manuscripts submitted to biomedical journal style, and it is based on the National Information Standard, that is NISO, which is a non-profit association accredited by American National Institute. And these standards are adapted by National Library of Medicine, NLM, for databases such as Medline and PubMed. So you must have seen, for majority of the journals which are in the PubMed, for them we follow the Vancouver style of reference writing. It was Vancouver who developed it in 1978 by the editors of medical journals. Most journals in medical science use Vancouver system to write the references. In this system, the citation in the text is done by the reference number. And remember that the reference numbers are in sequence. So now look at this slide very carefully. You need to learn the difference in the type of source. There are different types of sources. Like you have referred a chapter in the book, you are referring book, personal author, some personal author's book you are referring. You are using a book, authors and the editors, which has got more, some authors, and they also have n number of editors or one or two editors. You are referring some journal article. You are referring a journal article which was available online, right? Then ebooks, web page, dissertation and master thesis, newspaper or popular magazines, conference paper or government agency. So these all are the types of sources, and you need to understand that different sources have to be written in a different format. I am going to discuss the Vancouver style of reference writing in detail. Rest of the, I will just show the slides, and you can always download the reference styles in PDF format, and you can with a click of a button, by using the reference manager, you can get your source cited in the document, and it is always wise and advisable to use the reference manager rather than doing it manually. But manual is also important to learn. Why? Because sometimes the reference manager software do not put into the proper format the way it is done in the Vancouver style. Sometimes few of the things are missing, some of the points or the semicolon is missing, stop, a full stop is missing. So you have to put it manually, and it is important to learn it, how to do it manually also. So you cannot blindly rely on the reference management software, though they are helpful, but still you need to cross-check manually, right? So for example, the first one is chapter in a book. So if you are want to reference it, so you have to first write down the surname, author's initial, chapter title in surname, editor initials, editors, who were the editors, book title, place of publication, publisher, year, and the pages. So look at the example. There is one example being given, Metzer P.S., Polinemi A., Tarrant J.M. So these all are the authors, right? So in this section, we have first put the surname of the authors and then the initials, right? So this is the surname and this is the initial, right? So for example, if you come across my article and you want to reference it, my name is Gitanjali Kalyan. So you would be writing Kalyan G, right? If there is some other author with me, that is Neelima Singh. So you would be writing Singh N. So first you would be writing the surname and then you would be writing the initials. And then you would be writing the chapter title. Whatever the chapter title is there, that you would be writing. And then you would be writing the editors. In which book, which who all were the editors. So then you would be writing the names of editors. Here, Vogelinstein, Kinzer, W were the editors. And then you would be writing the book title, that is Genosis, Basis of Human Cancer. And then you would be writing the place of publication. And then you would be writing the publisher, that is McGraw-Hill. And then you would be writing the year. And then in the end, you would be writing the pages. And you have to make sure where you are going to put the colon, where you are going to put the semicolon, where you are going to put the full stop, where you are going to write P, and how you are going to write the page. So it is very, very important, and you need to sometimes cross check whether your reference manager software has put them correctly in place or not. Then book personal author. Some personal author's book you are referring, then you would be writing surname, initial, book title, edition, if available, place of publication, publisher, or the year. Right? So DIMSI PA, DIMSI AD. So this is the surname and this is the initials. And then coming on to the book title, Using Nursing Research Process, Critical Evaluation and Utilization, 5th edition, Philadelphia, Lippincott, Williams and Winkins, 2000. So this is how the book personal author is being referred. So similarly, book authors and the editors. So in the end, if the book is has some authors also and it has got some editors also, then you need to mention the same. Now coming on to the journal, if you talk about the journal article, so it is very, very important, because most of the time the journal they reject the articles if the referencing is not as per the format. So you have to, if you're following the reference Vancouver style of reference writing, you have to write down surname, initial, title of the article, journal title, or the title abbreviation if it is there, year, volume, issue, pages, and the DOI number. Okay, digital object identifier number. So this number helps us to find out that from where the article has been taken. So this helps in cross-ref. Usually when you are publishing anywhere in any of the journals, so always look for what all databases the journal is indexed in, and it should always have DOI number also, so that when you publish your work, the people come across your paper more frequently with the help of DOI number, and they tend to cite your paper. And once you have more citation, that increase your credibility to the scientific, that increase your credibility to scientific work. Right? So here with this example, like surname for S, Singh A, Dhillo MS, Tiwari MK, Sikho PK, incidence of bed sores among the admitted patients in a tertiary care hospital, Jipmer, 2015. This is the name of short form of the journal, right? Okay. That is Journal of Postgraduate Institute of Medical Education and Research, 2015, and this is the volume, this is the issue, and this is the page number. So after all the authors, we put a full stop, then we write the name of the title of the article, then we write put full stop, and then we put the name of the journal, year, then we put the semicolon, then volume, then comes the issue, and then colon, and then the pages, and then comes the full stop. On the other hand, if you have referred journal article on the internet, so you have to add in the end available from, and you have to also add internet. So like Gautam S, marriage and mental illness IJSP bracket में क्या लिखा है internet in the bracket we have got internet 2018 June it is on which date you have cited it but sometime the you would find that some of the articles are available online to a specific date and after that these articles are not available so it is important to cite the date when you accessed it and you have to also mention the volume and the issue and the page number and in the end you have to always mention available from what from where you have taken the article then coming on to the e-books some of the books earlier we learned the books which are were there in the hard copy format and you were referring it sometimes you get a book which is available online right so similarly like we learned in the journal which were online you have to write available from so similarly here also you have to write available from you have to mention cited on and you have to also mention internet so I hope all of you are able to appreciate first the name of the author sorry first the name of the author is being written then they have mentioned the title of the work what is the title this is the title and then they mention in the bracket of the title they mention internet full stop and then they would mention the place of publication and then they would mention the publication year and then they would mention on which date you have cited it on which date you found that book on the online and then you cited and then available from and then you write the URL from where you have accessed and then coming on to the web page in the web page again you write the author title in the bracket you have to mention internet place publisher date of publication date when it was updated or cited and available from where you have accessed it so this is the web page and the example is this is the name of the author this is the surname and this is the initial so Walter Wattles J phenomenological research guidelines 2 August 2014 available from the URL is being mentioned over here then dissertation and sometime you might not have the information about the publisher some of the online content do not have the information of the publisher and if it is not there you can skip it as it was not available right then dissertation and master thesis some of the theses if they are still in the library they have not been published you can always also mention there you can also use them and you can refer them right you can put their put it in the reference list so how first you have to write the surname initial title type of publication place year publisher and the year so like here this is the name of the author first the surname and then the initial and this is one of the study of our master students likewise all complete topic the title is being written and then in the bracket you would write msc nursing thesis unpublished because type of publication is unpublished and then you will write the place national institute of nursing education pgimer chandigarh and then in the end you would mention the year right then newspaper and popular magazines so if you are referring any of the newspapers or popular magazines then again surname initials full stop article title full stop newspaper title full stop date year and the semicolon then like similar here sing n well meaning spirit full stop the tribune april 12 2014 and 11 so that page number is 11 so this is how you cite a newspaper sometimes you get any information on the newspaper the feedback about some of the nutritional programs or some of the incidences you want to quote like these days lot of corona issues going on people are referring many newspaper articles or popular magazines when they are writing the papers so you have to refer them properly then coming on to the conference paper some of the conference paper are unpublished papers in that also you have to write the author's name full stop paper title paper presented at name of the conference date and place so you have to mention it likewise right so like similar like here the author's name This is the title, Experiences of Implementing a Nursing Approach for Management and Prevention of Bed Sores Among Bedridden Patients, a Mixed Method Approach, International Conference on Evidence-Informed Practice and Approach to Healthcare Reform. And then here the dates, place, and the year. So this is how it is to be mentioned, from which conference you have taken, what was the title, and what was the and which conference, like this was presented in International Conference on Evidence Informed Practice and Approach to Healthcare Reform. So this was the name of the conference, and which dates and where. Like government agency, name of organization or agency, title, place of publication, publisher, and year of publication. So similarly in government agencies, like you have to if you are referring any content from the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare guidelines. Say, for example, you are referring the administration of dexamethasone to an antenatal mother who is delivering the baby before 32 weeks of gestation for maturation of the lung. So this is a guideline which is available on the on GOI, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. You download the document and then you are referring that which one is better. Dexamethasone is recommended by the Government of India. And you are writing in a paper. So you would be first writing GOI, Government of India, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, right? And then you would be writing the title, right? And then you would be writing the publisher. And then station, then where the office is located. And then the year, like where it is located, New Delhi, India. And then you would be writing the year. So you see that there are different types of sources and they are being referred differently. There are e-books, web pages, dissertation, newspaper, conference, government agency, book chapters. These all are to be referred in a different format, and for different reference style, they are to be written in a different way. Right? Then coming on to the Harvard referencing style, it uses parenthetical system of referencing. A brief in text reference containing the name of the author, year of publication is given in the round bracket. Okay? Also called as author date based referencing system. So basically this, here the more focus is being given on the author and the date when you are referring. Harvard is actually a generic term referred to all the referencing styles that are author date based. Thus, this style does not have any official manual. Most commonly used in UK and Australia, the guide in the following section has been adopted from Charles Darwin University, CDU, Harvard Referencing Style Guide 2016 version. So here I'm just quoting, I would like you to focus on the journal article, right? So for journal articles, they would be writing the author of the article, family or the surname on the initial, publication year. Here the publication year is very, very important. And then we write the title of the article, then the title of the journal, and then the volume and issue, pages, followed by the page number of the article. This is how it is being written. So here they would write the author name. So here the writing author name is entirely different the way we wrote in the Vancouver style. In the Vancouver style, we wrote core S, comma. But here, they would put double commas. Core, comma, S, comma. Right? And then sing, comma, A, full stop, comma. Right? Yahan bhi full stop aayega. From here also, we will have a full stop. Then MS dot com. Dhillo, comma, MS dot comma Tiwari comma m dot k dot comma. And likewise here, then the year, incidence of bed sore among the admitted patient in the tertiary care hospital, JPMER, the same reference we learned in the Vancouver, volume 49, number 1. Here they are mentioning not in the brackets, the volume is not in the brackets, earlier it was in the bracket, no need was to write volume, here they would be writing volume, here it was semicolon. Right? Then the pages 26 to 31. So likewise, here is a difference in the reference writing style. And you need to focus on what reference style has been demanded by the journal. Then coming on to the APA style. So another important and very most, many of the journals also use this APA style of reference writing. American Psychology Association, commonly known as APA referencing, is very similar to that of Harvard referencing style. Most of the things are nearly same, like you put the comma after the surname, comma, and then initial and full stop and then comma. The same thing is being followed here. There are minor differences. APA is more popular in USA, although there does not exist much variation in formatting. However, before using a particular guide, there is a need to take caution what style your institution or the where you are publishing is demanded. System of referencing, it uses parenthetical system of referencing. A brief in-text reference contains name of the author, year of publication, given in round brackets. Thus, it is called as author date-based reference styles. Disciplines, which all disciplines are using, most of the social science disciplines are using it. It is also more commonly being used in education, nursing, and business. Right? So this is the APA style of reference. Here, I am also going to focus on the journal only. Right? I am not going to read all the styles, all the reference writing way for all the types. I am going to focus on the journal. So please come on to the author. This journal article here, first you would be writing author, comma, and then the initial and again comma, author, comma, and then the initial, full stop, then comma, and author, comma, initial, full stop, and then the year in the bracket, title of the article, title of the journal, and then you would be writing the volume. And here the difference comes. Here the volume and issue is being written like the way you wrote in the Vancouver style. Whereas when we are writing in the Harvard style, here it was written as volume and then issue, right? So here this format remains the same. And in Vancouver style, we write here P. And here they just directly write what are the pages. And then the DOI number is being mentioned. And if you are using an internet-based source, in the end we write retrieved from. Whereas in Vancouver style, we were writing available from. Right? So this is how it is different, and you can download PDFs with all the types of sources and the examples of the reference. And when you are writing even your assignments, I would recommend that we should start teaching this thing to the BSc students only, from BSc's this thing, so that student learn how to quote the references. Now important thing to remember is a number each citation in the super. You should put a number for each citation and number to each source is given in the sequence. And if you are going to cite the same source again, you have to put the same number. Say for example, when you are writing the paper, you wrote references up 1 to 20. Now after 20, again, you have to refer something which is already given in reference number 1. So you would put it 1 only. You won't write it 21. So you would write there 1. The name of the author may also be used in the text, but again, the author's name, we have to write the number, right? So this is MLA reference styles, Modern Language Association America. Referencing style has its publication in two different documents, MLA Style Manual and Guide to Scholarly Publishing, and MLA Handbook for Writers of Research Papers. So some of the journals are specifically give MLA reference writing. So, and they, in their author guidelines, they would give a link. They would give a link to open MLA Handbook for Writers and Research Papers. So by clicking on that particular link, you will get the format for writing the references. Both of the documents keep similar information and they keep formatting. Right? So here also use parenthetical system of reference citing. A brief in-text reference containing name of the author and page number of the sequence surrounded by round bracket is provided. Similarly here also, like we were doing in the APA style. This referencing style is used by various subjects of linguistic and literature. So for the literature or linguistic material or papers, they would be writing MLA. They will be using MLA. There is one more reference style, that is Chicago referencing style. Following guidelines of Chicago referencing style is prepared in using 6th edition of Chicago Manual Style published by University of New York in 2014. So you can download this manual and you can learn how to write the references for different formats. Rarely this is being used by any of the journal. Some of the journal, if you are using please download this manual from this New York University, and then you can use it. So now I'm coming on to the another very, very important concept of reference management, that is reference management software. So being a master student or a PhD student, learn to use reference management software. When you are doing the reference search, use the reference management software. There are three modes commonly being used. There are many I have listed in the slide, but I will be focusing only on first three, that is Mendeley, Zotero, and Envoy. Right? So what all things you would be requiring to use it? For Mendeley, it is a free software manager and an academic social network. You can make a social network with the help of Mendeley. You can connect to the other researchers also. So you need three things to use Mendeley. So first one is Mendeley Desktop. You can easily organize and search your personal library, annotate documents and cite as you write. Then Web Importer. Quickly add articles from any supported website directly into your reference library with a single click using Mendeley Web. And then Citation Plugin. This citation plugin is for the Word document. So I'm going to show you with the next subsequent slide what all these three things are. So this is Mendeley Desktop. For Mendeley Desktop, when you will down it, you would see this kind of icon. And you appreciate the icon, that is Mendeley Desktop. So this Mendeley Desktop icon, when you will open it, this kind of a window will open. In this window, here you can see I have created different folders, like already developed protocols, antenatal counseling, communication in NICU, counseling, discharge manual. And in different folders, I have saved different search, different material with along with the PDFs. You can appreciate the PDF. So when I will click on any of the thing, on the right side, the extract will appear, year of publication, authors, title, everything will appear. And you will also see there would be a link to open the PDF also. So you can open the PDF. And then once you, now you have downloaded 20, 30, 35, whatever the number of references you are going to use to write a communication in NICU. So you would be saving them here. And then what you're going to do next is you're going to, this is the first thing which is to be downloaded. That Mendeley Desktop is the first thing to be downloaded. And before saving all these things, you have to download Web Importer. So this Web Importer, this icon would be there near your search engine, the place where you put the URL address, you would find the Mendeley link. So once you have opened something, say for example, you have opened communication in NICU, and then you click any of the article, Helena Wigret, communication in NICU, parent perspective and view, and their experiences. So now you want to save it. You will click here. Once you will click here, the article will go into the main area of the Mendeley. And then you will click on the article, and on the right click, you will get which place you want to save it. So you would click, I want to save it in communication in NICU folder. I want to save it in any other, if say for example, antenatal counseling folder. So you will save it, and then you will open your Mendeley Desktop again, and you would see that this kind of folders would be there, and there would be references added to it. The third thing which you need is citation plugin. So citation plugin you will download, and you will, after downloading it, you will install it. Once you will install it, in your Word document, you would see Mendeley being written. Can you appreciate small red colored open Mendeley? So open Mendeley would be there. So say for example, here I have put the cursor after 2. I want to insert a citation 3. So I would click on Mendeley, open Mendeley. And open Mendeley would give me an option to insert the citation. So whatever the citation out of those 30, 20 I saved in communication in NICU folder, that will open. I will select the one which I want to enter, and then I will click insert. So once you will insert, you will get the reference in the end. Now another important concept here, you can appreciate it is very small, but if you focus here, it is below Mendeley, it is written American Psychology. APS style is there. So all different styles appear here. By click of a button, you can select which styles of referencing you want to use. If you want to use Vancouver, all the references will automatically convert into Vancouver style. You need not to manually change the commas, semicolons where to place it, and it would, your work will become easy. Say for example, you submitted your article to American Association Journal, that is Pediatrics, published by AAP. So that they asked for the Vancouver style of reference writing. And then you found that the manuscript has been rejected, and now you want to submit it to NNF Journal. So NNF Journal asks for APA style of reference writing. So if you have 40 references in your reference list, it would be very, very difficult for you to change the commas, semicolons, and everything. But with the help of this, you can do with a click of a button. So you will just open your document, and from Vancouver style of reference writing, you will change it to APA style here. And all of them would be changed into APA style of reference writing. So that is advantage of using reference software manager. Like you are doing your master thesis. You have given your content to your teacher to check. Your teacher is checking your introduction, and you have listed 20 references. And when teacher was reading a paragraph where the reference number 15, 16, 17 was referred, and teacher says this paragraph is not required, delete it. So along with that, when you are deleting that paragraph, along with all those 15, 16, 17 references would be deleted. And if you are not using a software manager, you will land up in a pool of trouble. All references beyond this, beyond 14, you have to manually change. But if you are using a citation manager, they will automatically change after deleting first three, that is 15, 16, 17. Three will delete, and the 18 will automatically become 15. So that is the advantage of using the citation managers. All your reference styles can be changed into another style with a click of button. All your referencing numbering can get automatically corrected, right? So then coming on to the Zotero, this is another software which is more commonly being used by people. So Zotero is a free, easy to use tool to help you collect, organize, cite and share the research. We need to download Zotero desktop similarly, like Mendeley, importer, plugin for the world. So this is the icon. This is how the icon of Zotero display when you download it. This is the Zotero desktop. When you click on the Zotero desktop, so you will have Zotero desktop likewise. And here also you have number of folders which you have created while saving your research. You can add the folders from here. The two things are appearing. So you can click on the folder, and then clicking on the folder, My Library will appear. Under the My Library, you can see number of folders I have created here. Book MCQs, Conceptual Framework, COVID-19 Diagnosis, CRIBS 4, Drug Errors, Family Integration. These all are the folders I have created. Under the Conceptual Framework, I wrote a chapter in a book on Conceptual Framework. So all my references are jotted down here. There were many others. This is a click which include all the references about the reference. And then again, you have to have a Zotero Word plugin. So here you can see, once you install it and your Word document, Zotero will appear. You will click on a Zotero, and then you will go to add or edit citation. You will click on the place where you want to enter. Say for example, here I want to enter. You will click here, and then you will go to add citation. Click on the add citation, and then it will be added. So this is bibliography. So why I wrote Word bibliography here, because PH is missing, bibliography. Because we have not numbered the references from which I took the information. Whatever the references I used, I just listed them down here in the end. So that's all about my topic for the today. So now the floor is open for the discussion.
Thank you, ma'am, for your elaborate speech on such an important topic. Your talk has certainly helped us understand the topic well. You also made us understand how important is accuracy of the citation and reference list in any research work. Thank you, ma'am. There are one question in QA box.
Let me see the questions. Okay. This is Bansari Patel to all panelists. Ma'am, it is very informative. Kindly share all slides. This is the only...
Ma'am, there. Ma'am, there is a one question by the Mathli Gupta. Ma'am, when we write a paragraph in a chapter, for example, in review of literature, we sometimes start it with author name, its initial, and in bracket the year of publication. Is it correct one or it changed with reference style?
Just a moment.
Okay, ma'am.
I was trying to
QA box, ma'am. In QA box.
Where?
In QA box, ma'am. QA box.
Question answer.
It's 3 o'clock.
Yes, I'm opening it. Okay, ma'am, when we write a paragraph in a chapter for EXROL, Review of Literature, we sometimes start it with author name, its initial, and in a bracket, the year of publication. Is it correct one or it changes with reference style? When you are writing a thesis, you have to take the format from your institute. Every institute has a different format. Like when I was doing masters at AIIMS, the format was like you mentioned here. We used to write the name of the author, and in the bracket we used to write the year, right? And when I came here and I started teaching at PGI, here the method was different. They never used to ask students to write the name of the author and the year, just a paragraph and in the end reference. So it depends upon the institution policy also. And secondly, you are correct, it also depends upon the referencing style being adopted by your institution. So you have to take that clarification from your institution. If they are asking you to use Vancouver style of reference writing, or they are asking you to write APA format, it will change with the format also, and it will also depend upon the institution format. So follow that only. Right?
Ma'am, no more questions are there.
Any other questions?
Ma'am, no more questions are there. Thank you, ma'am, for answering the question. And I hope all the participants must have enjoyed this session. Now, I would like to thank all the members of the Nursing Teacher Association of India, especially Dr. Farooq sir and Mr. Manish Kumar sir and Mrs. Poonam Thakur ma'am for organizing this wonderful webinar. And thank you for listening and watching. Thanks.
So there are 37 participants have attended.
Yeah, ma'am.
Earlier, maybe more. Now the number is decreased.
Ma'am, there are 39 participants.
I congratulate all of you for doing a wonderful job. I hope all the students will get benefit out of these webinars. And thank you so much for inviting me and making me a part of this teaching and learning activity. Thank you so much.
Thank you.